Okay, good evening and welcome to our combined middle school and high school spring concert. We're thrilled to have you with us this evening and really happy to have our symphonic band from Fernandina Beach High School here to play on our concert at Odom. This is a large part of their grade, and to meet the standards to pass the music performance class, they have to perform, and I have to witness them being an audience and learning how to act as an audience and how to listen and critique music. So if they're not here, they can't get that grade for that standard. So I feel sorry for them. This is our beginning band. I think it's about time to start, so please take these, put them on silent, like I'm doing, so that we don't have additional sounds coming into the auditorium tonight while we're playing. I think you're going to hear a big difference from what you heard at our holiday concert with this group. They have really come a long way. You'd be surprised how much they can learn in this short period of time when they try. So this is March Across the Seas.
Thank you. first expedition march was written by a South Carolina middle school band director for a festival band that he did, which is like our all counties, where they bring select members in from different schools and put together a group and perform. And he wrote this piece for their all county band, or all county, whatever they call it there. It's called First Expedition March. It's a little bit longer than the other pieces, and it shows off the different instruments as we go through.
Thank you.
And a few students, I need to recognize that a little extra this year. We had several of our students that went back in February and performed at First Coast High School as solo and ensemble. They compared the solo with a piano player and was graded by a judge from somewhere in the state, given a grade, and they earned a medal. So I'm going to present them with their medals this evening. One second.
Students performed a solo and was graded and received either a superior or an excellent rating, both of which is an exceptional feat for a beginner to do. Our first soloist was Gianna Brown, who received a superior rating on a flute solo. Gianna. Our next soloist was Cooper Hurst, who received a superior rating on a snare drum solo. Our next soloist was Orion Kirkwood, who received a superior rating on a euphonium solo. Palmer, who received a superior rating on a clarinet solo. Next soloist was Noah Sawyers, who received a superior rating on a snare drum solo. Next soloist was Gabby Gaskin, who received an excellent rating on a clarinet solo. Next, Charlotte McKinney, who received an excellent rating on a clarinet solo. And next, Jaden McCormick, who received an excellent rating on a tuba solo. It takes a lot of nerve to do that and prepare a solo and go in front of someone you don't know and have to perform it. You only get one shot. So these students did an exceptional job. All of the students received a certificate this evening of achievement for completing beginning band. Really sad that so many of them have chosen not to come back to band next year, but those who have, maybe will stick with it and will continue to do the solos and continue to move forward so that you'll hear their progress continue. So we're going to move on to our final selection. This piece, Scaling the Mountains of Time, was written by Robert W. Smith. Robert W. Smith is a nationally known composer who is a teacher at Troy University, where I went to school. He was my trombone section leader my first year in college. And now he makes more money than any of us think about. But pretty much any band anywhere plays something by Robert W. Smith because his writing is fantastic. So this is Scaling the Mountains of Time.
Thank you.
thank you for your patience. This is our symphonic band. Again, we're going to play a very varied program this evening. The first two pieces we played at our concert evaluation back in March, and we hadn't really looked at them much until the last week or two since then. And I think they were all surprised at how much easier that the pieces were and how much better they sounded on them, because they've all gotten better. They're better players now than they were back in March. So I think you'll hear a big difference. And then we have several faculty members here and other music teachers. I saw Mr. Johnson down here just then when I got out of the light where I can see. Thank you. Mr. Johnson does a fabulous job at Emma Love. Our students come so well prepared, and we're so blessed to have him down there. Just want to keep him happy. There's quite a few more. I can't see the back because of the light. So if you're one of our faculty members, thank you so much for being here. I'm not going to try to call names because I can't tell who's back there. But we really appreciate your support. That beginning band, seventh period, was the first time they played together since the holiday concert, because they're in two different classes. So we had a real frightening experience seventh period today, and then it came together. But we're going to open tonight with a piece called Gateway March.
Thank you.
march, but it's a little different march than what we played earlier. This is an English march. It's March of the King's Highway. It was taken from an English folk song. The Old Woman and the Bedlam. And it was written for the English school systems and for their elementary music for the students to sing. They said they don't reconnect their students with their historical music and to make their curriculum better. Well, so much of our musical traditions come from Great Britain, especially the bands. Your first original band pieces were written by English composers, one of which we'll hear in just a few minutes. But this is called March on the King's Highway. And it's a little bit slower style march than our march.
Thank you.
American Patrol. So, complete different style of music. So this is a swing style. We'll feel that different feel of the swing. The students don't play what they see. It's written just straight notes like this, but they play it to the skip. So they have to learn to feel that swing style to make it work. So this is called American Patrol.
Superior French horn solo. My sister!
embarrassing your system. Cyrus Hill for superior tenor sax solo. Owen Witters, superior alto sax solo. And Caden Cross, an excellent mallet solo. Our band received straight superior ratings again this year at our district concert MPA. We were the only middle school in Nassau County, too. There's only two more in all of North Florida, so we're real proud of them. They will be receiving certificates tomorrow in class, and our medals didn't come in. The eighth graders, I think I have enough that the eighth graders can get their medals, and the next seventh graders will be back, so we'll have them next year if we don't get them before school gets out. But what should have taken 2.5 weeks, it's been over 2 months, and we still haven't gotten them. We have everybody positioned. Okay, this next piece was written by Gustav Holst, another famous, important British band composer. This was one of the first pieces that was written originally for band, not for orchestra, and transcribed. This is from the second suite in F. This is the final movement. It's called Fantasia on the Dargasan. The Dargasan is a dance. You'll hear this dance going on through the piece. And imposed on top of this dance is Greensleeves. The dance is in one time signature, and Greensleeves is in another. So we had to move some people around to make sure they could hear each other, because it gets a little tricky in the middle. So this is Fantasia on the Dargasan.
Thank you.
was written by Christina Huss. I knew her as Chris Huss. She was in band in high school along the same time I was. And we played together in several honors bands up in Georgia when I was going through high school. We moved to college together for a little while. She did most of her teaching in South Georgia over the Ankara area. Is now retired. But this is a new piece that just came out this year. It's kind of fun to be able to play pieces by people that you know. I guess that means you're old. But you know the composer here. But this is Chris Huss's Brace for Impact.
Thank you. fun job. We're going to transition a little bit. So we played six tunes on our concert last Thursday, but a couple of them were a little on the long side, a little heavy side. I wanted to keep things a little light-ish. The next tune we've got for you is called Until the Scars. And it is the depiction of what happened after the Trojan War when Odysseus was making his way home. If you're familiar with the story, it doesn't go well for a really, really long time. And I hope that you will hear that conveyed in Into the Stars. Thank you. you on a little tour for just a second. If you started with Mr. Jernigan, if you started playing your instrument when you were with Mr. Jernigan, say that. Started before that, a couple of them started in different, not Fernandina. But the point there is that what you just heard them do, your kids can do too over the next 3 years. If you were in the all district band last year at all, either band. Another student going to Belmont, Tennessee. all going to be majoring in music, a couple of them also in a double major in other things. But there are other students and or seniors who have an opportunity to still make some money next year, even not as music majors. Lots of pep bands, basketball bands, volleyball bands, some marching bands will give you a stipend or per diem, or some sort of money if you do those, especially at smaller schools for marching bands. But a lot of universities give out pretty good per diems for pep bands. So just because you're not majoring in music doesn't mean that there's not an opportunity for money in college, and frankly, some really fun travel going to basketball games, volleyball games, tournaments, and that sort of thing. So we're going to close tonight's program. I'm going to let two students speak to you because I've talked enough. So I'm going to let two students speak to you a little bit this evening, and then we'll close the program. So Bridget and Emily.
Finally, I would like to thank both Mr. Odom and Mr. Jernigan for being such huge inspirations to me. I can't wait to one one day how students of my own just have the chance to inspire one student like you both inspired me. Thank you so much.
The tune was not written for its original purposes, and once again, once you hear it, you'll know. It was really meant as an entry of the gladiators to depict that really powerful moment. It got used in different ways over time, and that's okay. It's still a wonderful piece of music, and I hope you'll enjoy it.